As I mentioned before in Parliament, the Hong Kong government couple of weeks ago announced that there were 11 or so countries they would like to discuss an air travel bubble with. And I said that Singapore responded positively. So since then, officials have been having informal discussions about the concept of such an air travel bubble. Yesterday, I spoke to Commerce and Economic Development Secretary, Mr. Edward Yao, and he and I arrived at in-principle agreement to set up such a travel bubble between Singapore and Hong Kong. I think the parameters are fairly simple. Number one, we both recognize that we have quite successfully controlled the epidemic and incidence rates are low in both regions and places. Secondly, is that under the travel bubble, there is much less restrictions. No restrictions on purpose of travel or segments of travelers. So it's unlike, say, a green lane, reciprocal green lane arrangement, where it is only confined to business travelers. Here is for everyone. And there would be no control itinerary as well, which leads to the third principle, and therefore the way we control the risk. And to start with, the risks are low because we both have very low incidence rates now. But the way we replace SHN, quarantine, and replace control itinerary is through a test. We both agreed on pre-departure tests, but each place and each party can impose more risk, more tests if we would like to. So we will, from now on, both sides officials will enter into formal discussions to conclude this agreement. I think it's a significant step. It's a small step, but a significant one, because both Hong Kong and Singapore, we are regional aviation hubs, even global aviation hubs. And for two of us to be able to control the epidemic and come together to discuss and establish this air travel bubble, I think hopefully this sets a model and a template for us to forge more of such relationships and partnerships.